Welcome to another episode of Fresh Thinking by Snowden Optiro. My name's Ian Glacken. I'm an executive consultant at Snowden Optiro here in Perth, Western Australia. And this morning, today, I'm joined by Justine Tracey. Justine Tracey is the head of advisory APAC for Snowden Optiro. So she's my boss. So today we're going to talk about the role of a mine geologist, or the real role of a mine geologist. You may think there's a role of the mine geologist, but Justine is going to tell us what the real role of a mine geologist is. So Justine, why are you qualified to tell us about being a mine geologist?
Thanks, Ian. My background is in mine geology, and I'm very passionate about mine geology. So started off in West Australian mine geology about 25 years ago, and that's my foundation, and I feel like it is essential in the current job we do, which is resource estimation and reviews.
Thank you. Okay, so you obviously have the experience, and I know that. I've worked with you on projects. What does a mine geologist do?
The role of the mine geologist is critical for ensuring efficient mining of the ore body and delivery of the correct ore to the mill. Mine geologists can work in both open pits and underground. And the primary functions of the mine geologist really is to ensure they minimise dilution and maximise grade. That's the two primary functions I should always be thinking about during their job.
So how would you break that down in terms of variability?
What a mine geologist is really doing is using the mineral resource model. So the mineral resource model is the primary asset of the mine, which is used for determining the mine and the life of mine. And at the mine geology scale, this has been infill drilled, close to drilling for the grade control model. But when you're actually mining this grade control model, it's a closer scale. It's, you know, like it's what you can see. So there's so much more local variability. And this is what needs to be communicated to the operations to make sure that this material is being correctly delineated and taken to the correct spots.
So we've got the long-term model, the resource model. We've got the shorter-term model, the grade control model. And then what you're saying is that we might have additional local variability on top of that.
We do. And it's the mine geologist, which needs to be right on top of what these models are doing and what's predicted, but also what the difference is, and making sure that the operations is aware of that and we can react to these changes so that if there is additional metal or material identified, it's not being sent to waste when it should be ore, because this is a lot of value for the mine if it's correctly delineated.
So what would the typical daily task be for a mine geologist?
Yeah, okay. So daily mine geologist does do a lot of data collection. So they manage the material management for what has been brought up by the operations for the last 24 hours, and making sure that they've gone to the right locations. And this will involve going out to the run of mine areas to make sure it's correct. It's also talking to the operations and making sure that material's going to the right spots. And then it's also the big component is underground or in the open pit, and looking at the material as it has been moved, and making sure that it's being allocated to go to the right ore or waste locations.
So I understand and agree with what you've said. What one issue is, you know, why do we have geologists doing this work? You know, obviously they're called mine geologists, but, you know, where does the geology come into it?
Right, okay. So where does the geology come into it? It's really critical to understand the geology rather than just what the grade is doing. So it's predictive as well, because you need to understand what's going on beyond what's happening on that day, because you need to communicate and inform the shifts coming up to be aware of what's going on. So you need to know what's happening in the 3D space by using your models and your informing data, such as your drilling, and understanding what the geology sequencing or orientations is doing. So you need to have your geological foundation and understanding.
Yes, on that. I mean, my experience, I've got about 7 or 8 years' experience as a mine geologist, underground and open pit. And my first job was at a nickel sulfide mine, and I used to go around and see the miners every day. And they really relied on the geologist, me, and other geologists to tell them what's happening in the next cut and what's happening in the next thing. So what you're saying is that the mine geologist has got that knowledge of the ore body based on his or her knowledge of what's happening and the geology understanding.
Yeah, that's right. And then that understanding is also built up because we get the view of all the data and the assays and the analysis and the work we're doing to inform that decision. But saying that, Ian, your experience would have shown that those operators are very, very experienced in reading the ore body and understanding what's going on. So there's so much value in building a relationship with them.
That's true.
To them about what you're seeing,
yeah,
so that can help them understand what's going on, build that relationship so that they will help you to learn the things, because they're seeing the ore body 24/7, whereas you only get the opportunity to come down and see it for small periods of time through the shift.
Yep, I agree with that. So what would the qualities of an exceptional mine geologist be? What would we be looking for or aspiring to?
Yeah, sure. Interestingly, what I've found is that some of the best mine geologists weren't the ones who were academic, weren't the ones that did their PhDs or got the best marks at uni. They were the geologists which were good communicators. They were the geologists which were able to talk to anyone across different levels. And that's because mine geology is kind of like a bridging function, because you bring together this discipline across mining, across engineering, across operations, and also across metallurgy. So you need to talk to all different technical and operational people. I think another excellent attribute for a great mine geologist is curiosity. So really questioning what's going on, because on a local scale it can change really quickly. So you need to actually be quite curious about what's going on and investigative to determine those changes.
I agree. So you talked about building a relationship with all levels of people. I thoroughly agree with that. So if you were starting as a new mine, as an experienced mine geologist, you know, what would your first steps be? You know, what would you look to do to get started?
Yeah, so really it's the two things which you just said then was about building the relationships. So spend the time with the key people, not just your geology team, but the operations. So a great tip really is to spend a day, 2 days, or a week with the shift boss or the foreman. So if it's underground, do the underground runs with them, hear what their problems are, see what they're seeing. If it's open pit, get down and spend the time with the foreman and the crews and have their conversations at the operational level. And the other thing is really spend the time to learn your geology, so not just the mineralization, the stratigraphy and the sequencing and the aging, so you can understand what's going on in the bigger picture rather than just what the ore bodies are doing.
Yeah, I agree. And if I can just give you a little bit of an anecdote, when I first started as a mine geologist, I was fresh off the boat or off the plane in those days from the UK. Believe it or not, I had a full head of hair, an earring, and I guess I was quite different to the typical Australian sort of people that the people at the mine I was working at. So it took me some time to build a rapport with them, but you know, sitting down, talking to them and telling them and convincing them of your knowledge of geology, I mean, that's how it matters. That's all important. So I absolutely agree with you that communication, getting on with everybody, particularly the operators, the people that see the mine every day, is really important. So what would you say if you had to give some tips to early career geologists?
Yeah, okay. Well, it's that same thing. Communicate. Communicate with everyone, spend the time, talk your geology, bring up rocks to the surface. People want to see it, people want to hear it. Let the engineers know what's going on, not just your team. And share your information. And like you said, it builds a rapport, builds people's respect with you and what you know. And I guess one of the tricky things with mine geology, very much so in my day, I think it's changing now, is operations often see the geological function as a hindrance. So going down and mapping or stopping a drill rig from operations takes time, and takes time out of the mining sequence. And unless you communicate, they don't understand how critical it is to ensuring the adequate delineation of what is ore or waste. There's no point mining for mining's sake. And that needs to be communicated. The operators need to know that and understand what they're doing, and then they respect what you're doing. So it's really about that communication and sharing the knowledge. We can't do all of the job. We can't do all of the geology. So we need to bring them along and help us get our job right. So communicating helps that.
Yes, yeah, I agree. So if I was to sort of summarise, I'd say the roles of the mine geologist, just as you said, it's maximising the value of the ore, minimising the waste, making sure that we delineate the ore, making sure that we're understanding what's happening. One thing you haven't mentioned that, you know, we've talked a lot about on these podcasts is reconciliation, and generally the mine geologist looks after the reconciliation, but that's a whole another podcast. But I would agree with you. I mean, I think it's all about communication and working as part of the team and being the bridge between the operators, yep, and the mine manager.
Yep, definitely. And another couple of things which are really important for new geologists is really use your voice. So speak up if you're feeling overwhelmed, because it's a team effort, like Ian said. So if you're not sure of what's going on, bring everyone along for the ride. And lastly, speak up about safety. Be a leader in safety. If you don't feel safe, speak up or question it. Mining environments are hazardous, and putting yourself at risk for the sake of collecting a rock is not worth it.
Thank you. Thanks, Justine, for that. That was great. Very interesting. So this concludes our podcast. If you'd like to listen to more of our Fresh Thinking by Snowden Optiro podcast, you'll find them for free on our website, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and most of the podcast platforms. If you enjoyed this, please subscribe to the YouTube channel. Thank you.